Good morning, students. In this video, I'm going to tell you how can you make art integrated projects of maths. How can you connect art with your maths? So, all the subjects you have art integrated learning. Actually, the main object, the principle for art integrated learning is so that you can learn the things by your creativity, or you can how can you connect your creativity with every subject like the maths. It's really interesting to know how can you connect the maths with the art. Everything in the world having maths, like this is a pen and this is slightly colored shape. How can you measure the how much quantity of liquid or how much quantity of substance can be there in this cylinder? You can find it by using the maths. It means maths is everywhere. Though this is a rectangular board, and you can find if you are writing in this block, if you're writing 10 words, you can find how many words you can write in this board. It means maths is connected with everything. So there is everything. There is in this world, everything is connected with maths. So in art integrated project, we have to connect our maths with art. So I'm giving you only two chapters. You are free to choose any other chapters other than these two, polynomial and the quadratic equation. So in these two chapters you can easily make art integrated projects. So I'm going to help you how can you make this project by in these two chapters. Actually, you can also use the chapter mensuration if you know about the surface area and volume. So because you have studied that chapter in class 9, so you can also use that chapter for making your projects. But for these two chapters I'm going to tell you how can you make your projects. So first, I'm going to tell you a quadratic equation. How can you use a quadratic equation for making your projects? Actually, the projects you will make should have some art, should have some creativity. Most of the students have lots of creativity in them. So they can, think much better than me. So I'm going to help you. First, what can you do for art integrated projects? You can make some collage, or we can see some greetings, like in which you show your art and you show your maths. Like suppose a quadratic equation you are going to solve. This is x squared plus 4x plus 4. So how can you solve this equation by using your activity? So first, see the things. This x square, we can write it x into x is x square, and in place of this 4x, we can write x plus x plus x plus x. Okay, so I'm going to factorize this equation by using without using the methods, by using the activity. And plus 4, we can write it like 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. Now, what will you do? You can make a greeting card for it. Greeting cards which have lots of pages, and you can also decorate your greeting cards according to the things which you have. It means with your art. Yes, you can decorate your greeting card with your art. So suppose this equation we are going to solve it by using activity. So what will you do? You will cut a different color paper and you will say the size of this paper is x by x. Okay? Suppose you cut a paper and you will say the size of this paper is x by x. And again, for showing the x plus x plus x plus x, what will you do? You can cut the four strips of paper having the side x. This side should be equal to this one because we are taking this side as x. So this length can be 5 cm, can be 10 cm, it's up to you. So you will use different color paper for making your activities. Like this is a square paper having the side x and x, and another paper having the side x, and this is 1 cm. This length is x and this width is 1. So what should be the area of this rectangle? It should have an area x into 1, that is x. So you can cut 4 strips like this, x, y, 1. You can use different colors for making this activity. It will be really fun. So x, y, 1. You can use different colors, okay? So this is x plus x plus x plus x. X into 1 is x. Again, for showing 1 into 1 into 1 into, 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. How can you show it? You can cut a square paper having the side of 1 centimeter like this. You can also use different color for these squares shape structure. So suppose this is red in color, this one is green, these all are green in color, and these papers are, suppose you can take any other color, yellow in color. So now how can you show that, how can you factorize by using this card papers or papers, different color papers? Now arrange this XYX paper in next page like this. Suppose this is your card, and in first page you will write the name of the school, the project of your maths projects, and which chapter you are using as your project, and the session, that is 2021 and 22. So now in the next page you can show that you are solving the quadratic equation by using the activity. You can also paste these papers like in this manner without arranging them like this. Or in the next page, there should be also, you can use also creativity, your creativity there. And then on the next page, what can you do? You can stick these papers so that you can factorize it one, this equation, right? Now, suppose this is your paper. Now, you are going to paste it. You are going to paste these papers on this paper, on this greeting paper, so that you can factorize the equation. What will you do? You will paste like this, x by x. You will paste the paper having the side x by x. Now, these are the two strips. You can stick these strip here. Okay. Now again, you have two strips. Strips, you can arrange these strips like this. Are you getting my point? What are you doing? Actually, I'm making a, you can see the gridding. You're making a gridding in which a first page should be show what are you doing actually in this gridding cards. Or the gridding cards will have lots of pages. In first pages, you will show that what are you doing in this gridding card. And then on the other pages, you can show these are the strips of the paper, and you are going to factorize this equation by using these papers. On in the next page, what will you do? You will stick these papers here, like this. So, this sides having the x, y, 1, okay? Now, these are the four square strips. What will you do it with it? You can stick like this, two strips here, and again two are remaining, two strips here. So it means it will form a square shape structure. And if you want to find what are the sides of this structure, this will be, this length is x, and this was 1, x by 1. So it means the length, whole length of this strip will be x plus 2. Okay? And what is the length of this side? It is also x plus 1 plus 1, that is 2. It will also looks beautiful because of different colors you use here. So this is a square, and the factors of this equation is x plus 2 into x plus 2. We can also find the area of this square. How can you find it? By multiplying this by this. So you can also use different other equations to show how can you factorize the equation by using your activities, by doing the activities. So, and the other chapter we are going to, I'm going to tell you about how you can connect this chapter with the activities. This is polynomial. So, how can you connect this chapter polynomial with your maths, art integrated projects? You know, you can also use clay for making different activities. You can also make the video clips. If you are doing something like you are making a video, you can also make a video. You can also use different colors. But there should be some creativity. There should be some creativity. Not only the chart in which you make some you saw the equation in the chart. This is not okay. You have to make creative things. You should show your creativity in this art integrated and learning. So now polynomial, how will you connect the polynomial with your activities? You have seen you must have seen some bridges like this. How these bridges can be made? How they are connected with the maths? These bridges have the shape of parabola. Parabola. Actually, in chapter polynomial, you have learned about the parabola. Parabola, if you have a quadratic equation that is ax square plus bx plus c, and if you are going to make a graph of this equation, the graph will be a parabola. So parabola can be like this, it can be like this, it can be like this, or it can be like this. So these are the different shapes we have we must see in our daily life. So in bridges, actually we use the quadratic equation for making these bridges. Yeah, we can connect the most of the things with our maths. Like your milkman bring milk for you in a container which is cylindrical in shape and its measurement is 1 liter. So I mean, it means all the things are connected to the maths, though we know or not. So like you are going to the market and you buy some vegetables or the fruits, again you have to calculate these things. So it means everything in this world is connected with maths. So I'm going to tell you about the parabolas. So you can use this equation for making the parabolas. What can you do? Actually, you can make up bridges which having the shape of parabola. You can use different materials at your home, waste material of your home, so to make these bridges. So it will look so beautiful. And then you will show that these parabolas are formed by using the equation that is called the quadratic equation. So it means you can make a bridge and you can show this bridge in the shape of parabola, and the parabola is formed by using the quadratic equation. And again, you can use your creativity for making your maths projects. You can also make projects like, you can use the chapter surface area and volume if you know about it. In surface area and volume, you can show that suppose your milkman brings a type of container for milk, and this container has the capacity to fill up to fill the liquid that is 1 liter. Yeah, okay, 1 liter. Now, if the shape of this container is like this, actually he is very clever, and what he done, he made this type of shape in the container. It means it make a hollow. We can't say the hollow. It means this type of shape he made in his container, so that the liquid can be filled only here. It means what have he done? He decreased the quantity of milk in container. So you can also show by your creativity that what should be happen, and actually what is happening when the milkman is bringing milk for your home, or what he is doing, he is cheating, and how is cheating, he is cheating because the quantity of milk there in this container should be 1 liter, but by this figure, or we can say by this type of shape, he decreased the quantity of milk in this container. Because in this container, now the quantity of milk can be there will be the volume of this container minus this volume of the hemisphere, which type of shape you make in this container. So it means in maths projects, you show your creativity, your art for making your projects. Okay, that's all. And I will explain you again in Zoom class.